Well, good morning, everyone, and happy Vlogmas. First day of Vlogmas, and I welcome you to all the cheer and happiness for the next 24 days. Well, I started my day off this morning just wonderfully. I was up by 3. What else is new? I got up and I had my coffee. And I went on Amazon and ordered some Christmas gifts that I want to share with you. But I have to tell you that I started off Vlogmas yesterday in a meltdown. Yes, chirpy, happy Nanny, who you always admire for being up, was in a downer. And you know what? I don't know what set it off. I had such a wonderful day the day before with Matthew, and we laughed and I worked hard. Moosey had a wonderful day looking through all his memorabilia that I found, and it was a great day. Yesterday morning, I started off okay with all intentions of going out and finishing up the last minute odds and ends. Everything was going well until somewhere around 11 o'clock, and all of a sudden I had this gloomy feeling that came over me. And I know you've all been there, and I'm sharing this because I get that too. I want you to know that I'm always not always up. I am a strong person and I can recover from these things, but whatever set me off, I just lost my energy. I couldn't do what I wanted to do. I had good plans for the day. I just went into the bedroom. At that point, I can't remember whether Moosey was sitting outside or inside. Went into the bedroom, got into bed, and pulled the covers up to here, practically over my head. And I just stayed there until I fell asleep. And I slept a good portion of the day, waking up, going back to sleep again. You know, I think maybe it was an overload, that I was just overwhelmed. I physically didn't even feel well. I felt kind of weak. Such a strange feeling for me, because normally I'm not like that. Every once in a while I do get my downers. But you know, as I think back, I think as I was deciding what had to be done, I realized I wasn't going to put out my creche with all the animals. I wasn't going to put out the big Advent house with the little drawers that the children, when they were little, all used to come down before school every morning and take out their little treats and go off to school and say, "Good morning, Nanny," and off they would go. I wasn't putting up my Christmas village all over the piano because I don't have any little children coming to the house anymore. As a matter of fact, a lot of our family activities are, when we have them, are in houses of the children. And I think I might have had a letdown realizing that as we age, Christmases change. Memorabilia and nostalgia is wonderful when you're in that mood and you can look back and think of all these wonderful Christmases and memories where your own house, our big house, Moosey and I had this big, wonderful Currier and Ives type house where that was the gathering place for everyone. And that's over. That part of our life is over. And by the end of the day, it got to be 5 o'clock, and I knew I had responsibilities with Moosey. I knew I had to get up and make supper. I knew all the things I had to do, and I did. I got up. I was a little shaky, and I think, number one, I think my diabetes, my blood sugar was low, because that's what happens when it gets low. I get a little shaky. My legs are a little shaky, and that's a physical thing. That's not a mental thing. And I realized I hadn't eaten anything all day, maybe a piece of banana bread very early in the morning, and that was it. And of course, that will bring my blood sugar down. Plus, I had taken my metformin and my diabetes medication early in the morning, which keeps my numbers are really pretty good on my medication, so I didn't never have high numbers. Gave it to Moosey and kind of ate and went back to sleep again. That made me realize that my sleeping over the last two nights, getting up early, was not good, and I honestly was missing sleep. So I kind of slept all day and all night, woke up at 3 o'clock, and I was slept out, felt better, went into the kitchen, made my coffee, looked around, I had left the milk out, I had left the rest of the pasta meal out. I just went to bed and forgot about everything. But guess what? I've talked enough about that. Today I'm fine and ready to dig in again. I'm telling you all this because I know at Christmas time, a lot of men and women in their older years go into a little bit of a semi-depression like this. The holidays always happens, even younger people, for some reason or other, it evokes a feeling of downness, sadness, whatever. And I want to tell you that you're okay when it happens. It seems to happen to a lot of people, even Chirpy Nanny. So that's why I told you about this. But recover from it, get your mental attitude, positive thinking again, and know that we're here. We're thankful for so many things. We accept the life that we have might be a little more simple, a lot more simple, but we're here. We're enjoying the company of friends and family. Yes, life is different, but it's life, and we are here to enjoy it. So here we go with day one of Vlogmas. Now, my first problem is to figure out whether I should keep looking for male and female plugs inside this middle section of the tree, or should I dig into this and try and put all of these on, all these extra ones on. There's 150 of these. I haven't done this in years, mainly because since we've been in this cottage, Moosey and I have had artificial trees that come with the lights. And Micah or Matt has put them up, the lights light, no problem. Now, Moosey always did this, or the boys always did it when we lived at home. And I don't know whether to begin or what. So I'm going to start with this. And then Moosey, that has been his traditional job. Are you up for it this year, Moose?
Oh, yeah, baby.
Good. Well, we always start with a big bag of red ball ornaments. Moosey prefers those to go on first, mainly because they're easy and because in the daytime, the red really gives us a nice light. Now, we're living in the same room most of the time with this tree, so we like that look. But we have a collection of ornaments that goes way, way back, lots of nostalgia, and I really like to put a lot of those on. So Matthew saved the big red tub of what we normally would put on the tree. And he said I overdo always Christmas trees and everything. But you know what? This year, because of energy levels and we'll just do what we can, we might only get a few of those special ornaments on, but I'll share some of those with you. One thing that I do want to share with you right now is this. You know what this is? This is a record. Now it's steel. This is probably one of my most prized possessions. This is a record of my father singing Dinah. Now, ladies, do you remember that song, Dinah? Dinah, is there anyone finer in the state of Carolina? Well, I'll tell you who Dinah is. Dinah was our dog growing up all those years, and Dinah finally passed over the rainbow when I was in college. But Dinah must have been 16 when she died, and my brothers and I had Dinah. Now, the reason that our doggie was named Dinah, was because I think I might have told you, my father graduated from Holy Cross College in Worcester, Massachusetts. He was a boy from Worcester, grew up, was born there, grew up there. And he met my mother during a concert. I don't know whether I've ever told you this story. Maybe I'll save it for another time. But he met my mother when they were in college, when his glee club went down to New Jersey to sing. And he was the tenor soloist in the glee club. And one of the songs that he sang alone in the glee club was Dinah. And that's why our dog was named. Now, I have to find a way. Now, this was in that box that Moosey was going through in the last video, all the box of memorabilia saved. The date on this is May 14th, 1924. He graduated in 1927 from college. This record is almost 100 years old, and my father is singing. So we have to take this to someone who can reconstitute this and put it on a CD or something that we can listen to. And I have heard this way, way, way when I was younger, and even possibly in our married years, I still heard it. So, one of my treasures. And that's starting my day off great. I'm hating this job already. Look at all these, at least they light up. So I'm gonna start on the bottom. I'm gonna start on the bottom and see how I go. But I gotta go around and around, right, Moz? Is that the way to go? I gotta walk around this tree?
Yeah. And I think what you have to do is get them unraveled in one long string.
But there's 150 of them.
That's why I said two-man job, you give me one end. So that you have one string and not a bunch of...
Yep. Okay, well, I'm starting on the bottom here.
Yep.
And I'll holler for you when you can hold the other end.
No, yeah, I would...
Bye. Speaking of sharing memorabilia from Christmases ago, this is my original Christmas stocking, the faded felt part, which I got on my very first Christmas. And even says my name on it. My mother saved it all those years and I saved it. And when I started making these memorabilia stockings, oh gosh, 30, 40 years ago, Colleen was a baby, so she's 45. So it was a long time ago. And I started making them for the whole family. And these are the red velvets, boys are green. And I superimposed my stocking on here. And then what we do is we put all sorts of things that mean things to us. I have some pins from Ballycumber where we spent a couple of Christmases for 2 weeks within the past 15, 20 years. My teaching apple that someone gave me, pictures of the family from, well, when we lived in San Francisco, all sorts of little awards from my real estate days and various other things. And pins from all the different places we visited. And Moosey's, believe it or not, his mom did the same and saved his stockings. His didn't fade as much as mine did, but there's his. Now, he has pins from his army days, things that were on his hat, his various things, pictures of grandkids that gave him little awards from various things. Can you see all these wonderful, wonderful mementos? So this is why we call them memory stockings. Now, for some reason or other, Moose got a red one, but all the other boys got green. I lined them with quilted fabric. What?
That's green.
Is this green? No, it's red. Mosey. I lined them all with quilted, different kinds of quilted fabric, and I put old laces and trims on there. And I'll show you some of my girls. Now, the reason I'm showing you that is because I have to make Lauren one since she's lost her stocking somewhere. but Matthew always keeps all the stockings under the bed. I told him never put them out in the garage in a box, because one year I think a mouse ate two of Bridget's children's stockings, so I had to remake a couple of those too. So stockings stay in the house in a special place. That's why I was able to find mine. So I will show you some of the girls where I put parts of their mom's wedding dress and also parts of my wedding dress, little bits and pieces that over the years I've cut up. They would look pretty here on the fireplace, but I have so much going here that I probably will hang them. I think last year we hung them on the fireplace in the bedroom. So that's where I'm going with our stockings. Oh, making a little headway here. Now, so far as sharing gifts for you to ideas of gifts that you can give to family members and friends, I have several that I'm going to retell you about from last year because some of them were so good. And I think the one that most of you loved the most and ordered the most and probably was the most practical for every grandchild to have next to his bed or anyone, and I did the same last year, were these emergency lanterns. Now look at the light that they give off. These are absolutely amazing. And all you do is lift it up. There's no fumbling around for buttons or turn on switches. It's just lift it and push it down. And you all went crazy over these. So I'm gonna talk about these again. They make a great gift. And I gave them to Colleen, and Shani has one next to her bed, and Lauren, and Matthew, and Dolly, Matthew's kids. They all have these, and we all need these at some point in our lives for power outages. They happen everywhere. So I'll tell you about those again. And also, all of you love these. Now, you know I love candles. I'm always lighting them. And this is the best invention. I think I might have seen this on Natalie, the beauty diva, my friend. But I bought these last year. We have two of them somewhere. Somewhere we've misplaced one. But you push the little button. This goes up. Then you push this button, and it lights a candle. And this gets hot right up here. And there's a little handle here, and you just recharge it, has a little recharger. I think you get two of them for about $10 or $12. These are wonderful. Forget those things that you have to push and pull to light candles. I light all my candles instantly with this. So I will tell you about this again too. And I do have a bunch of new ones. The ones that I'm going to start with are the personalized gifts that might take a little time for you to work on. I know that you all loved my recipe box idea that I gave to Jenny when we had one of her showers before she got married. She requested that. And Bridget, her sister, in tears that day, said, "Nanny, please, my birthday's coming up. Would you do the same for me?" So I did the same for Bridget with family recipes that over the years they all remembered, and I wrote them all by hand, and I threw in some of my mother's, her mother, just recipes that mean a lot. And I think that's one of the nicest gifts that you can give to a granddaughter or a great-granddaughter or even a daughter, of things that she loved growing up, or even a guy who was a good cook. All my sons were great cooks. So I've already showed you my mantle, and I'm going to keep the brass plates and of course the Holy Family, because that's what Christmas is all about. But I'm going to show you my berries. They are shrinking a little bit. These are the foraged greens and berries that I did get outside. Now I did spray them with hairspray, as someone recommended, but although they're not falling on the ground yet, they do look a little kind of tiny and wilted. The greens seem to be holding up okay, but you know, I have another month to go. We usually leave everything up. It might be a little brittle. So I think I am going to redo some of the greens. And I did tell you I have a collection of antique Santas, and I'm going to put the antique Santas on this corner where I usually put them around here. and pretty much do the same things, but maybe with some new foraged greens or some greens that, like for instance, I think these up here on the top, these greens are artificial. So I will be doing that. And this is my Advent candle. I will be putting pretty candles in here, of course, the purple and the pink, the significant colors. And I will explain all the different figures on the outside. I love this wreath. It's an Advent wreath. And normally I would have my creche here, but as I said, I don't think I'll be putting it up this year. I'm saving
my... Lucy, nanny.
You want to hang him up on the tree? Put him on the tree.
Check out Lucy.
Upon the tree.
So I do have to go out because I managed with those 150 lights, I managed to get about 2 feet on the bottom of the tree done, but only in the front. So I'm figuring I need about 3 or 4 more boxes of 150 lights. So I have to get some more lights. I need to do a little food shopping and I'm running back to Trader Joe's. I think that Danish Kringle, that wreath of the almond morning, whatever, a lot of you are familiar with it, and Dubby has used it every Christmas morning. We do have several events lined up already, and I think it would be a lovely gift to bring. Margie is hosting everyone. She just bought a beautiful big 9-foot tree, and hubby Mike snapped on Black Friday. He snapped a great 65-inch TV deal for a phenomenal price. So she wants to have all the kids up, her brothers and sisters and us. And we're going up there for a brunch on the 10th, Sunday morning the 10th. No, that's the 11th. And on the 10th, Debbie is having her Lollapalooza for all her grandchildren and all her kids, where she has hired the Santa, and Moosey and I go dressed in costume. I think I showed you pictures last year. It's a hilarious day. Sorts of things for the kids to do, and it's a lot of fun, baking and everything. So we have that weekend booked up, and I think I'm going to get a couple of those Danish Kringles because you decorate them with greens in the middle. It makes a beautiful wreath, maybe put some little red bows around, and it's a delicious pastry, a very thin pastry. One of the tastes that I like, I think they have a few different varieties, but we like the almond. So I think I'll stop by Trader Joe's too. I did want to show you that our roses are still blooming. Look at these. These are not the bright red ones that smell so beautifully. Those are still blooming as well, but aren't these pretty? So I will close now and take you along with me when I get out and do what I have to do. Well, I'm outside now, and I just wanted to show you the wreath that I put on the front door. It's quite old, and I think I might have to spray a little red paint on some of the bows, but it's pretty, it's old, and as you know, I like to hang on to things for as long as I can. One thing I wanted to say, I noticed that several of you noticed that Patrick had landed on the grandfather clock, and I think Marty was the very first one to say she noticed it, but several of you, more than several, noticed. Well, he's popping around, so keep your eyes peeled. We'll play that game again, and we will hunt for Patrick every video, and you have to tell me when you spot him. We'll see you. Oop. Uh-oh. My windshield wipers don't work, that's for sure. Well, I've got clicks going here. Well, I'm on my way out now, and I have my list of food and things I have to get in the way of lights for the tree, and maybe I'm going to get some artificial greens if I've had my foraged greens up for a while. I don't know whether I want to deal with more of those. Anyway, know what I have to get. All right, so I'm sitting on the edge of my trunk just outside of Hobby Lobby. And I did get some greens, but you know what? The prices of garlands are $79.99, $39.99. Now they are 50% off, but I think I might have to go foraging again, but I did buy some that I paid $10 for because my greens on the mantle are wilting and I'm gonna have to do that. Look what these are. I am gonna tell you, this is going to be for the most magnificent Christmas tree. It's an appetizer that I'm not gonna tell you until I make it what I'm gonna make with this. And what else did I get? Oh, I went into Big Lots and I found my lights. Christmas tree. So I will close by wishing all of you a very, very merry Vlogmas, and I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm home from my shopping, Moosey and I are ready to have supper, and this is our first day of bringing you cheer and joy. Thank you all for loving us. Thank you for enjoying. I love you. And God bless us all.